Several local firms ending the month with earnings reports, starting with Aboitiz Equity Ventures, which posted a 21% drop in its third quarter profit to 7.6 billion pesos. This brings its nine-month net income to 18 billion pesos. Its power unit accounted for 70% of its net income, while its non-listed food unit, Pelmico, fully recovered from its first quarter loss of over 530 million pesos. Meanwhile, DMCI Holdings saw a 28% decline in its nine-month bottom line to 20 billion pesos. The Consunji-led firm cites lower shipments and double-digit contractions in coal and nickel index prices, which brought down its mining unit, Semirara Mining and Power. Speaking of Semirara, it suffered a 66% dip in its third quarter bottom line due to higher base effect, fewer shipments, and lower forex gains. SMPC's nine-month net income is now down 37% at 22.6 billion pesos. In other news, Double Dragon subsidiary Hotel 101 completes its acquisition of a 6,500 square meter commercial plot in Madrid, Spain. It's set to begin construction of Hotel 101 in Madrid, which aims to be completed by the fourth quarter of 2025. Double Dragon expects to generate around 8.8 billion pesos from the condotel. And finally, Macro Asia confirms its joint venture. Lufthansa Technique PH is currently studying plans to construct a two-bay hangar in Clark Airport. This $100 million facility will be used for maintenance, repair, and overhaul services for large aircraft like the Airbus A320. Asian markets ended Tuesday trade on a mixed bag. This is China's manufacturing data weighed. The Hong Kong Hang Seng slumped 1.7% after China's factory activity posted a surprise contraction in October. Japan's Nikkei 225, meanwhile, managed a gain of 0.5% after the Bank of Japan left its rates unchanged and made its yield curve control more flexible. The Japanese yen, though, slid to a near one-year low for the month. Bourses in the region posted steep declines, with the MSCI Asia Pacific Index outside Japan recorded its third straight month in the red. The South Korean KOSPI index led losses, tumbling 7.6% this October in a month marred by geopolitical tensions, high interest rates, and worries over China's economic recovery. Some notable stock movements in the region. Asiana Airlines bucked the regional downswing on Tuesday, with its shares surging over 8%. That's after it said it would reconvene a board meeting in early November to decide on whether it should accept a merger proposal from Korean Air, South Korea's biggest carrier. Here at home, Philippine shares saw modest gains on possible window dressing. But it wasn't enough to pull it out of a rut, as the main index saw a monthly loss of 5.5%. PhilStocks Financials' Japheth Tanchanko says the market will need to see positive surprises to see an improved November performance.
If you're going to look at the numbers for the last 10 years, November has usually posted an average return of 0.26%. So you can say that historically speaking, November is one of our gaining months. Okay. At the same time, if you're going to look at standard deviation, November has been one of the most volatile months in the year. So based from the numbers alone, we can say that there's a possibility of November being a very volatile month with the possibility of a gain.